whatever we could do within a $4 million aid budget.
But with NASA's $40 billion budget, Kasing believes they had the resources to pull off a hoax if they couldn't make it to the moon.
The reason I believe that NASA and the government faked the moon landing was basically it was technically impossible to do it. And they simply had to come up with some sort of alternative that they felt the public would believe.
Kasing theorizes that the lunar landings were actually filmed in Nevada's high desert at the top secret military base known as Area 51.
Area 51 is one of the most heavily guarded facilities in the United States. If you went in and tried to get some information, you could be shot and killed without any warning.
Russian spy satellite photos of Area 51 reveal not only a series of hangars that resemble movie sound stages, but also barren moon-like areas, which coincidentally are covered with craters. Compare this photo of a lunar crater, allegedly taken from the moon's orbit by Apollo 10, with this satellite photo of a crater at Area 51. Even astronauts acknowledge the similarity of the terrain.
It has a stark beauty all its own. It's like much of the high desert of the United States.
Could billions of people really have been fooled into thinking the Nevada desert was the moon? Kasing believes it's possible, and maybe the real reason Area 51 is so heavily guarded.
This is a very secret base, and with good reason, because undoubtedly the moon sets are still there.
And if they are, no one's getting a look at them anytime soon.
Up next.
Tranquility Base here.
If the lunar module landed with 10,000 pounds of thrust, why is there no blast crater? Plus, was this footprint really made on the moon? And later, 10 astronauts die under strange circumstances. How far could the conspiracy reach? Find out when Conspiracy Theory returns.
We've all been led to believe that on July 20th, 1969, the Lunar Excursion Module, also known as the LEM, carried American astronauts to the surface of the moon. But could it have simply been a prop lowered by wires onto a movie set? Bill Kasing says that this may explain the absence of engine noise in the official NASA footage.
The noise level of a rocket engine is up into the 140, 150 decibel range. In other words, enormously loud. How would it be possible to hear astronauts' voices against the background of a running rocket engine?
Picking up some dust. 3 feet, 2.5 down. Straight shadow. Four forward, drift into the right a little. Contact light. Okay, engine stop.
Is this evidence that the footage is actually fake? A sequence shot in a controlled environment here on Earth? Just months before this historic landing, a prototype LEM was flight tested at Ellington Air Force Base. While NASA cameras record the test flight, Neil Armstrong struggles to control the unwieldy craft. Then, at approximately 300 feet, the lander flies wildly out of control. At the last second, Armstrong ejects. And floats to safety. If the lander was so unstable and difficult to fly in the controlled environment of Earth, then how could the LEM land six times flawlessly in the alien environment of the moon?
The LEM had a single engine mounted dead center, and then they had little push jets, thruster jets, a couple of them up on top. This was supposed to control their attitude as they came down. Well, I'll tell you a secret. The instant you moved your tail in that cabin an inch, you would change the load pattern it would begin to tilt, and it would start that thing spinning.
The arguments that have been arrayed on the side of those who believe that the lunar landings were a hoax are very elaborate, and they have to be to support a theory like this. In the end, there's one set of evidence that is irrefutable, and that is that there are footprints, boot prints, still on the lunar surface.
But conspiracy theorists say that the footprints themselves are suspicious.
The surface appears to be very fine-grained as you get close to it. It's almost like a powder.
To have a powerful rocket engine blast the surface of the moon, blasting away all of the dust, and then find footprints surrounding the lunar lander, that to me would be an impossibility.
Photo after photo reveals that the lunar surface surrounding the LEM is covered with footprints. But Kasing says there's something even more difficult to explain.
The fact that there's no blast crater under the LEM is one of the most conclusive pieces of evidence that I find supporting the hoax.
In fact, no sign of a blast crater is visible for any of the six lunar landings. But LEM specialist Paul Fiel says he can explain why the lunar module left no crater when landing on the moon.
The amount of thrust that you need coming out of the bottom of the descent engine is about 1,500, 2,000 pounds of thrust. And all that does is just push dust away. There's no burning or anything like that.
Yet NASA's own scientific illustrations clearly depict a blast crater.
Then there's one other point. If they had truly landed on the moon, this dust would have then descended on the lunar lander, on the foot pads, and we find not a trace of dust on the foot pads. When I discovered that alone, I said, no way am I looking at a lunar lander that landed on the moon.
Could it be that the LEM was just a prop on a giant lunar movie set?
When Armstrong said, "That's one small step for man and one giant leap for mankind," the footprint that he made could have easily been made in Area 51.
Kasing points out that the LEM's departure from the lunar surface is even more suspicious.
In the footage of the ascent stage going up, what you don't see is an exhaust plume coming out of the rocket engine nozzle. But what do we see? We see the ascent stage suddenly pop up without any exhaust plume whatsoever, as though it were jerked up by a cable.
Is this evidence of a conspiracy? Was the government capable of such a massive cover-up?
To propose that this was all faked and a hoax, they have to say that every piece of evidence, that every physical scientific test that one could offer to support the reality of the lunar landings, they have to say that all of those are fake.
I would say that my conviction that Apollo was a fake was really not according to one specific piece of evidence, but it was cumulative. This whole thing was a fake.
Coming up.
We're getting a picture on the TV.
If there's no air on the moon, why is this American flag waving? Plus, could these official NASA photos have been doctored?
All of the photographs were faked.
And later, is it possible for humans to have survived the deadly radiation in deep space? When Conspiracy Theory continues.